Welcome y'all to another Skip Barber race here in iRacing. This week we're at Laguna Seca, a track did okay in last season, and we are here with Gem Knight from the Conelanders Assetto Corsa League and also the Child's Play Truck Series. Good luck, y'all.
Green, green, green.
And we did not get that great of a qualifying lap. I, however, did break into the 38s in practice.
Clear on the right. You got a slow car on the right. You're on the left, three wide. You're on the left, three wide. You got a slow car on the right. Clear.
Ah, yes, the fun that is turn one here.
Right side. Clear on the right.
How'd you fare through that?
I watched it firsthand.
But did you make it through?
Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure he was the one who started that.
That sometimes is how that works. Just happy to see we were able to sneak through some of it. That was unfortunate.
Left side. Clear on the left.
Person's name looks familiar.
That was a chill of a start.
1:06.976.
No joke.
Now, if we can just get a line run, we can stop just hemorrhaging spots. The biggest problem was we made a couple of mistakes during lap one.
I'm sorry for you to get hit, man. Ridiculous. Turn one.
Hopefully we're going to be able to pass this person sometime soon, because I don't think they're helping us right now. Pretty sure the guy behind us is thinking the same thing. Little bit not how I wanted to do that. Just need to calm down. Because we are not running the lines we need to be running, and it's costing us. You figure out a good place to set up to pass this person. That late apex, or whatever you want to call that, where you kind of miss the first one and just apex the second one, definitely works a lot better than a double apex. Adrenaline's still going. Need it to calm down. That was a good turn. Fortunately, we could see where he was, otherwise that would have ended poorly for us. He also kind of went to the left, which was good. Just not getting it done. Should have peaked and then gotten back over. Yeah, me too. Because I know I'm faster than, like, the person two cars in front of me that I just can't get past. And he's unfortunately causing a bit of a train. And I know these other two folks are quick.
There's no way I'm catching Dennis.
You in second?
Yep. I'm just in the right place on that lap one crash.
Kind of how Sebring went for me. Really, really trying to get... Would really like to get past at least one of these folks. If I can't calm down and actually just run some decent lines, it's not going to happen. I am still just kind of tweaked. I'm making stupid mistakes. At least we pulled some distance from the person behind us. Well, that sucks for that person. I kind of felt might happen because this person is making it difficult.
On the straightaway.
I'd rather take a 0x.
Yeah, I guess right now I don't blame you since you're going for your C-class. Okay, stop being stupid. Remember what I said about stop being stupid? That was not it. Wow. Like, I'm just doing the opposite. Okay, so I'm over pushing that turn, so we need to make sure we get off the gas earlier. I'm just going to go through what I'm doing wrong, not trying to be negative, just trying to help myself mentally. And I really want to kind of ride that curb there on that last turn a little bit after the apex.
Gee, well, surprise. Christian strikes again.
Somebody seems unhappy. I'm forcing it too much. How many laps do we have? We still have a lot of race left. Okay, so I think that guy was near us a second ago. I know we can do this. Gotta stop making all these silly mistakes. Because that's all it is a bunch of little mistakes. I need to get into position for the last turn under the front stretch. So I think that's where we can get him. As soon as we can get past him. And I don't think we'll see him again. And that's not going to get it done. Not sure if we're going to be able to catch up to anybody in front of us if we do get past this person. I'd still rather do it though. Hoping we could take advantage of that. Nope. Mental mistakes. It's frustrating me, and that's not helping. Just need to keep up pressure. Anything else? Try to force a mistake. On his part, not ours. Because I think we're faster than him by enough. Mainly because we keep running into that territory of having to be careful that we're going to run him over. There we go. That might be enough. I swear this person's braking in weird places. Now we have someone that was able to catch up. This is extremely frustrating. But I just don't know how I can get past him. I don't have the confidence to be able to do it in a lot of the turns where I need to. See if we can outbrake him here. Okay, I think we did a bit more than outbrake him there. Sorry about that. Went a little bit deeper than I really wanted to. However, I don't think that was like ridiculously too deep. But y'all will be able to tell long before I will. This is going to be fun.
Keep to the left. Clear on the right.
So, yeah. Just assume the nice thing and think that he knew he was already clear. Well, if he had trips, he probably did. Really wish I had trips.
You think I'd be slower behind somebody, but nope.
What do you mean? You
did.
I was actually faster running behind somebody than with clean air in front of me.
Were they faster than you?
No, we're about the same because he's keeping up with me. He let me by.
But yeah, he probably wants a ride. Or he wants to trade and actually work together.
Oh, we aren't catching the guy in front. The guy behind isn't catching us either.
That's like the second time that dude has done that. Unfortunate for him. At least we didn't touch him or come near him that caused that. I'm not really happy with that pass. And if I needed further proof that I really need to start hitting the open practices to start practicing passing people, yet another good indicator of that. Or just being able to do a lot of things, honestly. Now the question is he going to be catching up to us again? A bit too quick there. That's fine. But yeah, consistency has been one of my biggest problems here so far during practice. And today during practice, I thought I had it somewhat a lot better, since I was getting low 39s and 38s fairly consistently. Before I stopped practice, and I had to take a long break though. I think that was the problem, is that I had a bad mentality in going through warm-up before this race, because I was rushing to try to get back up to speed, which is not helping. If anything, that is instilling bad habits. And not good ones. Well, I admit I went a little wide. I still think there was more room to be had there. But again, I will find out here in a little bit to see how much of an ass I was. And yeah, it's bad that I just assume it was my fault. And if I didn't mention it, track temps I think are 105. It's a bit cooler than default weather, but not a whole lot.
You've got two laps to go.
Wow, those other nine laps sure melted away quickly. Running at least reasonably consistent times from the couple I've seen. And one of the biggest things I noticed that's helping a lot here, and that I was struggling with in practice, was nice slow turn-ins. So I think I was turning in too quickly. But it was causing me to pinch the turns. And if anything, that was causing me to not be able to get on the gas as early as I need to.
You just got the white flag. That means one more lap to go.
And back over pushing. So I think we're definitely faster than kind of looks like most of the people that you got stuck near. Doesn't look like we're much faster than the people that are in front of us though. Because they've just pulled away. I wish I could have done it cleanly. Oh yeah, and this is only a single split. Looking forward to watching the bear run. I know he's really quick. And you know, this is the only track, I think last season was when I saw him here. I don't think I've ever seen him in any of the other races. Oh, here we go.
Good racing, Dennis. Or David.
That was interesting. Would be a lot happier with that had that not terrible pass. At the very least, had I not locked up my brakes, that would have gone a lot better. I should have either been closer in. Yeah, I should have been closer in, and or at least started braking early enough to where I could have started my turn. I'll admit, it was probably a bit of desperation that got me, because I was getting very frustrated being stuck behind him, and I know I was quite a bit faster than he was. And anytime I had a bit of a run, it was not a good place to do it. I was setting up poorly. And so, I mean, all that kind of feeds in. It didn't help that it took a long time for me to get into my rhythm as well. Good to hear Gem Knight did really well, came in second. And we never did get on pace to where I wanted to be. Considering this was slightly better than default weather, we should have been in the 38s. May not have been able to consistently hit those 38s, but we should have been in the 38s. Tomorrow should be a lot better when we actually get some decent warm-up time and can get mentally focused properly. Because I really want to sit, I mean, that to me I think is the number one problem here today was I just never could get focused. We definitely know some things we need to work on, and that's what we're going to do for tomorrow. I will say it was also nice that I have gotten better about being behind people that are a lot slower than we are, because I did not run the guy over. With that, if you liked, leave a like. If you didn't, leave a dislike. If you have any questions, suggestions, feedback, or advice, drop it in the box below. Lucky races, and y'all take it easy.